Well, do they know more than they're letting on? A Scottsdale couple now being called persons of interest in the disappearance of a Tempe baby. Investigators believe Jack and Tammi Smith know more about the disappearance of Gabriel Johnson than they're letting on. The couple claims the boy's mother, Elizabeth, offered to have them adopt the boy, but the child's father was against it. Well, that happened last month, right before Elizabeth ran off with the baby. Now, she was arrested in Florida, but that boy is still missing. Thanks for choosing us tonight. I'm Katie Rammel.
And I'm Steve Irvin. Elizabeth Johnson's twin brother says he doesn't believe his sister would hurt her baby. ABC 15's Mary Ellen Resendez is joining us live with more of what he had to say today.
Steve, Robert Johnson says he was hoping that his twin sister Elizabeth would call from the jail where she's being held in Miami Beach. She did not call. He says if he does get to speak to her, he's going to tell her that he loves her, misses her, and to quit being so stubborn.
Robert Johnson would not interview on camera, but he sat and talked to us about his relationship with his twin sister, Elizabeth. He says she is stubborn and hard-headed, and while he doesn't believe she would ever harm her 8-month-old son, Gabriel, he also doesn't believe her story that she gave him to a family she had met at a San Antonio park. Johnson says he and his sister were close growing up, as they were tossed between foster homes until they were 12. That's when they moved to Scottsdale to live with their father. The two had a falling out shortly after he introduced his sister to his friend Logan McQueary of 10 years. Robert says while he loves and supports his sister Elizabeth, he believes McQueary is capable of raising Gabriel. Meanwhile, McQueary puts out a national plea.
You know, don't worry about getting in trouble or anything like that. Take him to a fire station, any place, hospital. We're just asking, please.
Tempe police have joined forces with the Center for Missing and Exploited Children to help find little Gabriel. They believe he is alive and are asking the family that may have him to come forward.
I'm going to say that if you have baby Gabriel and you can turn him over to a safe place like a fire station, a hospital, in Arizona we use the term safe haven, of course, but that might not be a nationwide term, but we're asking anybody, you can drop him off somewhere where he'll be safe, you can walk away from it, and all we care about is locating baby Gabriel.
If you have any information on where baby Gabriel could be or any information at all, call this new hotline. It's 1-800-THE-LOST. Live in Scottsdale, Mary Ellen Resendez, ABC 15 News.